Good night, teacher.
Hi, good evening.
Good evening.
How are you?
Great, teacher. Wonderful.
Okay, how was your day?
Oh, my day was really, really nice.
Okay.
Busy. Enjoy it. Everything. It was right.
Did you travel today?
Yes, I went to Sonsonate, from Santana to Sonsonate. And in the bus station, I rode a bus and to Nahuizalco. I went to
Oh,
Nahuizalco, yeah.
now
But
is
I returned at 1 p.m. The activities designed for today, it was so quickly.
Okay.
Yeah, but sometimes I have to spend at least 4 hours at least
4 hours.
at driving. Sometimes
Okay.
I use my car, but at some time we have to use the public bus,
Okay.
right?
Yes.
Yeah, but
But
it's okay.
your job is important, but in some cases it's boring. Oh no, for you?
No, it's not
Boring now.
boring. It's boring. Sometimes boring when I rode a bus and I have to travel, for example, from Santana to Ahuachapán or Sonsonate.
By bus.
I sleep during the travel,
Okay.
around maybe during 1 hour and a half, maybe.
Oh.
But it's not close. It's away from the distance is around maybe 60 or 70 kilometers.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I have to
Okay.
travel around 150 kilometers a day sometime. Yeah.
Interesting.
Right, it's interesting.
Okay, is it the time to start? How are you, Ever?
Fine, thank you, teacher.
Okay. What? How was your day?
So tired.
So tired. It was
Normal.
difficult.
Normal.
Normal. Okay. Excellent. Now, in this occasion, we start the class right now. Vamos a empezar ya con ustedes dos porque los demás veo que no se han conectado, pero tenemos mucho material que ver, entonces vamos a dar inicio. Did you read about last class?
I think so, teacher.
Okay. What topic did you see yesterday?
Well, I think that we complete the irregular verbs.
Irregular verbs. What else?
We and different kind of activities.
Tell me an example
For
using
example,
irregular verbs.
simple in a question or in a simple
In a sentence, tell
in a
me one
sentence.
sentence using irregular verbs.
Oh, today I went to Sonsonate City. Yeah,
Yeah.
I took a shower. I saw many friends. Yeah,
Interesting.
yeah.
Okay,
Different things,
excellent.
yeah.
Now tell me one sentence using regular verbs.
Me or
You,
ever?
yes, you.
Regular verb.
Yes, one sentence using regular verb.
Okay. Let me see. In the past or present?
No, in past.
In past.
Yes, in past.
Regulars or irregulars?
Regular.
Oh, I went to Rome. But regular is the
Went is
same.
irregular.
It's irregular. Oh,
Yes.
let me remember.
Regular is when you add at the end
I cut a tree.
ed.
At ED at the end.
Yes. They are regular. I
I
walked.
walked around 4 kilometers today.
Okay, I walked 4 kilometers today.
Yeah.
Excellent. Now, this is the topic for today. Where were you born? Where were you born? Please repeat after me. Where were you born?
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 You born, born.
You born, born.
Yes.
Yeah.
In this class, you will learn to form positive and negative statement with the past of be. And then, okay, where were you born? ¿Dónde nació? ¿O dónde naciste? Where were you born? ¿Dónde naciste? Ese es el tema de hoy. This is the topic for today. And it's very interesting and nice. A nice
yeah,
topic.
So.
Yes. And then, we have our first grammar. It's called statements with the past of be. Statements with the past of be. Aquí vamos a trabajar con el verbo to be en pasado. What is the verb to be? ¿Cuáles son las formas del verbo to be? Did you remember?
Be was where?
I are, am.
I are, is. Esas son las formas del verbo to be en presente. I'm, ¿cuál otra? I'm, are, and is.
And is.
Am, are, is. Esas son las formas del verbo to be. Am, is, and are. ¿Ya? Son las tres formas del verbo to be en presente. Ahora, ¿cuáles son las formas del verbo to be en pasado? We have a three, we have a two forms. That is, was
and were.
And were. When I use was, you can use was with the third person, he, she, it, but with I too. Esta was lo vamos a utilizar para las terceras personas que son él, ella, esto, esta y con yo, con I. Con eso vamos a utilizar el was. Y el were, we can use with you, we, and they. You, we, and they. You cuando es usted o es en plural o ustedes. Vamos a utilizar siempre el were y el was only when third person and I. ¿Ya?
Yeah.
Now, this is the most important things for
it's
this
like,
topic.
It's like the rules, teachers.
Yes. First, here we have the formula to apply it for this past of be. The formula is subject, in this case is I, plus was or were, cualquiera de los dos, was or were. Here we have was and we have were after the subject. Plus complement, complemento. Primero va el sujeto, luego va el was o el were, según lo que aplique. Luego tenemos el complemento, el complement. Okay, look these examples. I was born in Korea. I was born in Korea. Yo nací, where?
In Korea.
En Corea.
Korea.
I was born in Korea. Yo nací en Corea. You were pretty young. You were pretty young. Aquí
Ya.
estamos utilizando el you. Miren, y va con where. Que es lo que les acabo de enseñar ahí, ¿verdad? La imagen que tenemos. You were pretty young. O pretty young. What is the meaning? You were pretty young.
Estaba muy chico.
Eras muy joven.
Muy
Young es
joven.
joven. O estabas, porque eso significa, el verbo to be significa ser o estar, ¿verdad que sí? Ser o estar. Entonces aquí eso quiere decir, yo fui o yo estuve. Yo fui o yo estuve, ser o estar, porque es el pasado del verbo to be. You were pretty young. Usted estaba muy joven. Usted estaba muy joven o eras muy joven. Tú eras muy joven. Now, she was 17. She was 17. What is the meaning? She was 17.
Ella
Ella
tiene
estaba
25.
en sus 17, en sus 17.
Yeah, o como es ser o estar. ¿Cómo lo podemos traducir? El was, ser o estar.
Ella tenía
Estaba,
diecisiete.
tenía.
Ella tenía, podría ser, ella tenía 17. She was 17. Ella tenía 17. O ella andaba en sus 17. O ella estaba, porque es ser o estar. Ella estaba en sus 17 años. She was 17. O ella tenía 17. We were born in the same year. We were born in the same year. What is the meaning? We were born in the same year.
Nosotros nacimos en el mismo año.
Yes. Nosotros nacimos en el mismo año. Next. They were in Korea in 1998. They were in Korea in 1998. Ellos nacieron en Corea en 1998. Now, here continues. I wasn't born in the US. In this case, you can use this verb be with negative. Aquí mire, podemos ver, tenemos el was y el were, pero con el negativo. Wasn't, please repeat after me, wasn't,
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 weren't,
weren't.
weren't,
weren't. Cuando pronunciamos al final el negativo es porque estamos hablando de negación. Dice acá, I wasn't born in the US. Yo no nací en Estados Unidos, in United States. Yo no nací en Estados Unidos. You weren't very old. You weren't very old. Usted no estaba muy viejo. Weren't very old. Next. She wasn't in college. She wasn't in college. What is the meaning of this one? She wasn't. Ella no estaba en la universidad. She wasn't in college. Ella no estaba en la universidad. Next, we weren't born in the same country. We weren't born in the same country. Esta es la positiva y esta es la negativa. Miren, la positiva es we were born in the same year. In negative, we weren't born in the same country. Nosotros no nacimos en el mismo país. Next one. Positive is they were in Korea in 1998. En negative, they weren't in the US in 1998. Ellos no qué, no estuvieron en los Estados Unidos en 1998. Here we have the contractions, wasn't and weren't. Wasn't is the same, was not, and weren't is equal, were not. Was not and were o were not. Cualquiera de las dos pueden usar. Miren, aquí está completo el was not y el were not también está completo. Y si lo ponemos como contractado, decimos wasn't and weren't, weren't and were not and was not. ¿Ya?
Yeah.
Ok. Here we have our first examples. Can you tell me one example using this formula about this part? One example.
I was born in Santa Ana.
I was. Voy a poner aquí el I. I was born in Santa Ana. Here we have the structure. Subject I was in this case and complement born in Santa Ana. Was born in Santa Ana. Yo nací en Santa Ana. Yo nací en Santa Ana. Can you tell me another example? Díganme dónde nacieron. Ever, for example. I was born. ¿Dónde nació Ever?
I was born in Cabañas.
In Cabañas. I was born in Cabañas. Another one, Luis Chávez. I was born in. ¿Dónde nació? Where were you born, Luis Chávez? No está ahí quizás. And then Juan Villanueva. Ah, ya me dijo Juan, ¿verdad? Okay, Lillian, where were you born, Lillian?
I was born in Aguachapán.
In Aguachapán. What about Anita? Where were you born?
I was born in Morazán.
In Morazán. I was born in Morazán.
Where were you born, teacher?
In Morazán. Ah, I was born in Armenia, Sonsonate.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Yeah. I went to Armenia last week.
No. I remember that. I was born in Tangamandapio. No, it's not true.
It's not true.
I was born in Armenia, Sonsonate. It's the reality. Yes. Now, can you, Lillian, ask to Anita, where were you born? Hágale la pregunta, esta, ¿ve? Where?
Okay.
This is the question. Where were you born? ¿Dónde nació? Sí. Ok.
Anita, where were you born?
I was born in Morazán.
Okay. Anita asked to Ever the same questions.
Ever, where were you born?
Ever?
I was born in Cabañas.
Okay. Now Ever asked the same questions to Luis Chávez. Where were you born?
Where were you born, Luis Chávez?
Yo creo que no está ahí. No se ve ahí. Bueno, se está conectado, pero quizás no esté en su puesto. Y Juancito ya está ahí. Juan Villanueva. Ok, quizás solo se han conectado, pero no están ahí ahorita. Ok, ask to me. Please, tell me.
Where the bar is at?
I was born in Armenia, Sonsonate. Ok, is it clear this part?
Yes,
Yeah?
teacher.
Now, ok,
I think that.
now tell me in negative. Tell
Okay.
me in negative. Si yo le digo, pregúntele que si él nació en Estados Unidos. ¿Cómo hacemos la pregunta? Okay.
Did you born in United States?
Did you born in United States?
Anita.
O para que no le cueste. Vamos a ver, did you born in United States? Pero como vamos a utilizar el was y el was y el were, entonces pongámosle mejor. Was you, let me see. Pregúnteselo así, vamos a hacer una cosa. Pregúnteselo
Impressive.
así, where were you born? Y Anita le va a decir así en positivo y también en negativo, ¿ya? Vaya, le dice, where were you born? Anita va a decir, I was born, ¿dónde, Anita?
In Morazán.
En Morazán. ¿Un negativo? I wasn't
I
born
wasn't
in the United States. Excellent. Now, Anita asked to Nazario the same questions.
Nazario, where were you born?
Where were you born?
Hi, Anita, good to see you. I was born in Santa Ana City. I wasn't born in Korea.
Okay. Now, Nazario asked to Ever the same question.
Hello, Ever, good to see you. Where were you born, Ever?
I was born in Santa Cabañas. I wasn't born on Bingmar, Bingmar, en la marca.
Okay, now Ever ask the same questions to Lillian. But in this case, ask her this one. Where were
Lilian,
your
where
mother
you born?
mom, your mother born? Así pregúntele ahora. Where were your mother born? ¿Dónde nació su mamá?
Lilian, where were your mother born?
Hi, my mother
¿Puede
was
decir?
born.
She
She
was
was born
born, ¿ya?
in Concepción de Ataco.
En Ataco. Ok. ¿Y negativa, Lilian?
She wasn't born in the Panamá. In
En
Panamá.
Panamá. En Panamá. Yes. Excelente. ¿Ya? ¿Ven cómo podemos cambiar la estructura para hacer otro tipo de preguntas? Aquí le pueden preguntar dónde nació tal persona. Podemos utilizar un nombre. Por ejemplo, where were your sister born? Por ejemplo. O puede ser, where were Anita born? Where were Anita born? ¿Dónde nació Anita? She was born in Ataco, for example. She wasn't born in Panamá. ¿Ya? Aquí solamente podemos cambiar el sujeto. Ya vamos a ver ahí las preguntas cuando lleva la W questions, que también lo vamos a ver más en esta misma presentación. Right? Is it clear this part or do you have any question?
It's clear.
It's
Clear.
clear.
Yes.
Okay. Now continue with our presentation. Here we have some exercises because practice is very important to us. The instructions are complete these conversations with was, wasn't, were, or weren't. Here we have positive and negative answers. Complete these conversations with was, wasn't, were, or weren't. Now, I need two volunteers, one woman and one man. Volunteers?
Okay, teacher.
Okay, Nazario.
That's right.
Okay, ¿y una chica? Thanks, Anita.
Thanks, Lily.
Oh, thanks, Lily.
Hi, hi.
Thanks, Lily. Or both, or both.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
I went to a taco.
Yes.
2 weeks ago.
2 weeks ago. Ah, okay.
Beautiful
Anita,
place.
Anita is Mary and Nazario is John.
Right.
Okay. Try to analyze the correct answers. Anita, start, please.
Okay. I called you on Monday, but you weren't at home.
But you weren't at home. Why weren't?
Because it's the first person.
No, weren't is because it's negative.
It's negative.
It's negative. Weren't. Oh, you choose another color.
All right.
Okay. Me gusta ponérselos así para que ustedes vean los verbos. Yeah. I called you on Monday, but you weren't at home. Te llamé, dice, el lunes, pero no estabas en casa.
Yeah.
Como estamos hablando de
it's
you,
true. Estamos I was working.
Ah, yeah. Interesting.
It's true. It's true.
Now, you continue.
No, I wasn't. I was in the beach all weekend.
I was
in the beach all weekend.
In the beach all weekend. I wasn't. Okay. Continue, Anita.
That's nice. How was
the weather
there?
How was the weather there?
The weather there?
¿Por qué estamos usando el was? Porque el was lo usamos en tercera persona. It is para cosas. Okay, how was the weather there? ¿Cómo estuvo el clima ahí? Young?
It was beautiful.
It was beautiful. It was beautiful. Continue, please. Mary?
Where you sibling there?
Where?
Your sibling there?
Where your siblings there? What is the meaning of siblings?
Hermanos.
Hermanos, general. En uh-huh. general. Uh-huh. Excellent. Were your siblings there? ¿Estuvieron sus hermanos ahí?
No, they weren't.
No, they weren't.
I was alone. It was great.
I was alone. It was great. Weren't here. And
was.
Excellent. Now, another volunteers. Please. Hear me?
Me.
Okay, Lilian and Luis Chavez, are you there? Oh, Juan Villanueva, are you there? Okay, no están todavía ahí. And then, you and Ever.
Okay.
Okay. Please, Ever is Bill and Lillian is Jackie. Okay, start, Bill.
Where are you born? The juice, Lillian.
Were you born in the US? Were you born in the US, Jackie?
Yes, I was. My sister and I was born here in Japan.
Yes, I was. Let me change the color. Yes, I was. My sister and I were born
in Japan.
In Japan. Were born in Japan. Continue, please, Bill.
I was born here too.
I was born here too. What? What about your parents?
Where are they born?
Were they born here?
Well, my father was. He was born in Miami, but my mother was born in the USA in Chicago.
In Chicago. Let me see.
Chicago.
Okay, my father, what? Can you repeat, please? Well, my father?
My father was.
Was. Okay, he?
He was born.
He was born.
In Miami.
In Miami.
Yes. But my okay. mother was born in the USA, in Chicago.
In Chicago. Well, my father was. Let me see. Well, Bill, Jackie, yes, I was. Bill, I was. And where? And Jackie was. He was. Here. He was born in Miami, but my mother was born in the US in Chicago. Chicago, really? My parents were born in Chicago too. Where? Excellent. Now, yes, tell me.
Se firma en la segunda oración y luego se vuelve a firmar.
¿En cuál de las dos? ¿En la primera o en la segunda conversation?
En la segunda.
Ok, veamos.
Bill pregunta si nació en Estados Unidos. Luego responde que sí.
Vamos a ver. Were you born in the US, Jackie? ¿Nació en Estados Unidos, Jackie? Yes, I was. Sí. My sister and I were born here in Japan. Ah, esta.
Weren't.
Yes, yes. Sería.
Weren't.
Weren't. Yes. Weren't. My sister and I weren't born here in Japan. Excellent. Así es, miren. I weren't born here in Japan. Okay. I was born here too. What about your parents? Okay. ¿La demás? Analyze, please. It's okay.
Yes.
Do you have any questions about this exercise?
No, teacher.
No.
No. Okay. Now continued with this conversation. That is, I was born in Korea. En las conversaciones, ahí van toda la gramática que estamos viendo. Van a poner atención cuando escuchen el where y el was, que son lo que hemos estado viendo ahorita. Okay, please pay attention to the audio and read at the same time. I was born in Korea.
Where were you born? Page 100. Conversation. I was born in Korea. Listen and practice.
Where were you born, Melissa?
I was born in Korea.
Oh, so you weren't born in the U.S.?
No, I came here in 1999.
You were pretty young.
Yes, I was only 17.
Did you go to college right away?
No, my English wasn't very good, so I took English classes for 2 years first.
Well, your English is really good now.
Thanks. Your English is pretty good too.
Yeah, but I was born here.
Okay. Did you listen again? Or do you want to listen again? ¿Quieren escucharlo de nuevo? Or it's okay?
It's okay.
It's okay. Okay. And then, can you tell me if are there any new words for you about this conversation? New words?
No, teacher.
No. Where were you born, Melissa? I was born in Korea. Please, I need two volunteers to read this information.
Me, teacher.
Okay, Lillian and?
Go ahead.
Okay.
I'm Chuck.
Okay.
Lily is Melissa.
Melissa.
Hey, we can change the name, please.
Yeah.
I don't like it.
And okay. Then put your real name.
It's a joke. Don't worry.
Okay.
I'm Chuck.
Okay.
Where were you born?
Lillian?
Melissa or Lillian?
Okay.
Where were you born, Lillian?
I was born in Korea.
Oh, so you weren't born in the U.S.?
No, I came here in 1999.
You were pretty young.
Yes, I was only 17. Yes, yes.
Did you go to college right away?
No, my English wasn't very good. So I took English classes for 2 years first.
Well, your English is really good now.
Thanks. Your English is pretty good too.
Yeah, but I was born here.
Okay.
Okay, thanks. Thanks for your participation. Now, can you tell me what is the meaning of right away? Right away. What is the meaning? Significa de inmediato. Did you go to college right away? Dice que si fue a la universidad de inmediato. Right away. Both words are de inmediato. It's the meaning is de inmediato. Yeah.
It's like just right now.
Yes, right now. Okay, let me see another. Really, really good. Really good now. Thanks, pretty good. Okay. Yeah, but I was born here. Okay, do you have any questions for this conversation? If you see, here we can apply the uses of where and was in past. Yeah. Do you have any questions for this conversation? Or everything is okay?
It's okay.
It's okay. Now continue with this topic. Now here we have questions with the past of be. Questions with the past of be. Dice que son las preguntas con el pasado del verbo to be. El pasado que son el where y el was. Y el presente del verbo to be, ¿cuáles son? I, am, I am, o are, ¿verdad? Am, are, is, es el presente del verbo to be. Y el pasado es was y were. Now, when you need, do a sentence at the beginning always be where o was. Acá siempre va a iniciar con el where o con el was cuando se trata de una pregunta. Aquí cambia la fórmula. Miren cómo va la fórmula. First, you put WH word. Why WH? Because it's where and was. Porque empiezan ambas con W. Por eso se llama WH word. Pone primero el verbo en plus was en where. Cualquiera de los dos, el que aplique, el was o el where. Plus subject, el sujeto. That is here, el sujeto. Plus complement. Here we have this example. Were you born in the US? Were you born in the US? What is the meaning of were you born in the US? Can you
¿Naciste
tell me?
En Estados Unidos?
¿Dónde? ¿Dónde naciste?
Naciste, no, aquí no sería dónde, sino que solo dice
¿Naciste en Estados Unidos?
Ya, yeah, ¿naciste en Estados Unidos? Y le dice, aquí estamos utilizando las short answers, miren, las respuestas cortas, la yes no question, esas estamos usando acá. Se dice, yes, I was, sí, nací. No, I wasn't. No, no nací. ¿Por qué? ¿Cuál es la diferencia? ¿Por qué acá lleva where y aquí lleva was en la respuesta? Can you tell me?
Porque está hablando de I.
Yes. Porque acá al inicio estamos preguntándole a él, ¿verdad? Y el you va acompañado por el where. Y ya para responder, como nos está preguntando a nosotros, y estamos hablando de nosotros, vamos a utilizar el was. Were you born in the US? ¿Naciste en Estados Unidos? Yes, I was. Sí, nací. No, I wasn't. No, no nací ahí. Esas son las yes, no questions. Las respuestas cortas. Si ustedes pueden ver las yes no questions, las utilizamos en todo. Solamente para decir sí o no. Una respuesta cortísima. Súper corta. Now, second one. Was your brother born in 1984? Was your brother born in 1984? What is the meaning of this? This question.
¿Tu hermano nació en 1984?
¿Nació su hermano en 1984? What is the answer? Yes. He was.
Yes, he was.
¿En negativo?
No, he wasn't.
No, he wasn't. No, he wasn't. Next one. Were your parents born in Hanshin? Were your parents born in Hanshin? What is the meaning of this part? What is the meaning of this question?
Sus padres nacieron en Hanshin.
Mm-hmm. ¿Nacieron sus padres en Hanshin? What is the answer? Yes.
Yes, they were.
Yes, they were. ¿En negative?
No, they weren't.
No, they weren't. Now, acá tenemos la otra estructura. Acá ponemos solamente con el inicio del where y el was, pero si vamos a preguntar algo más, por ejemplo, aquí le dice, where were you born? ¿Dónde naciste? Aquí va primero la W questions al inicio. Where, was, when, what. Todas las que inician con qué, dónde, cómo, se llaman W questions. Entonces aquí inicia. Where were you born? ¿Dónde naciste? Acá cuando va eso, Cambia la fórmula. Primero va esto. Esto que va acá igual, ¿verdad? Dice, va a la WH Word, que sería esta, porque WH Word plus el wasn't where, que es esto, where, plus subject, que sería you, and plus complement, que es born. Aquí cumplimos con la estructura. Where were you born? ¿Dónde naciste? What is the answer?
I was born in Korea.
I was born in Korea. Yo nací en Corea, en Corea. Next one. When was he born? When was he born? Aquí estamos utilizando el when, mire. What is the meaning of this question? When was he born?
¿Dónde nació él?
Aquí
¿Cuándo
es
naciste?
cuándo, when.
¿Cuándo nació? ¿Cuándo
¿Cuándo?
nació?
¿Cuándo nació él? What is the answer?
He was born
¿1988?
Él nació
¿85?
en 1985. Él nació en 1985. Now, what city were they born in? What city were they born in? Can you tell me what is the meaning of this question, please?
¿En qué ciudad nacieron ellos?
¿En qué ciudad nacieron ellos? What is the answer?
They were
They were
born
born
in
in
Seoul.
There were born in Seoul.
In
There
Seoul.
were born in Seoul.
Seoul.
Ellos nacieron en Seúl. ¿Ya? Aquí, como pueden ver, usamos, si vamos a preguntar cuándo, dónde, qué, vamos a ponerlo primero. Después va a ir el was o el were, continues with subject and continues with complement. This is the formula. Now, here we have our first exercise. The instructions are: complete these questions with was or were. Complete these questions with was or were. Okay. Can you tell me in number one? Where? ¿Cuál sería ahí la respuesta en el number one?
Where?
Where were your parents born?
Where? Where were your parents born? Okay. Where were your parents born? ¿Dónde nacieron sus padres? Now, in number two.
Where
Was you?
you in, no, where?
No, it's where.
No.
Because you can you use pero dice you and your
You
family.
and your family.
You and your family. Yes. What is the correct? Was or where?
Was.
Where you?
Vaya, vamos a poner los dos. Was and where. Analyze. Please analyze the rest of the questions and tell me what is the correct was or where and why. ¿Y por qué?
Where, porque está hablando de
Where.
ellos, de los padres.
Pero dice you and your family.
Yeah, I think that is
Ah, no sé, él, somos nosotros. You and your family, usted y su familia somos nosotros. ¿Y con
Pero
we cuál
solo.
vamos a utilizar?
Pero también puede decir ustedes. You, ustedes.
Ya.
¿Dónde nacieron ustedes?
Dice usted y su familia. In this city, dice que se estuvieron o estuvo usted y su familia en esa ciudad el año pasado. ¿Estuvo usted y su familia en esa ciudad el año pasado? ¿Cuál sería entonces, was o where?
Was, entonces was. Está
Sería,
confuso porque.
ajá, en este caso no sería was, were, porque el
Está hablando
was,
de
segunda persona.
aquí estamos hablando de you and your family, o sea, nosotros o ellos. ¿Ya? Y el was lo vamos a utilizar ¿para qué?
Solo para tercera
Solo para
persona.
terceras personas y para mí, ¿verdad? Para I. Pero en este caso somos we, somos nosotros. Si yo digo, vaya, Anita, usted y su familia. Entonces, ¿son they? ¿Son ellos o son we? Somos nosotros. Varios en plural. Ya, yeah. And then the correct answer is where. Are you? Yes. Now, what about number three? What nationality?
Was your first English
Was
teacher?
Was your first English teacher? Are you sure?
Yes.
Why were? Why were? ¿Por qué sería were?
Because it's for we, you, and they. Word.
No, but in this case, let me see. Here, my number three. What nationality was your first English teacher? It's about, ahí le está preguntando acerca de su profesor, ¿verdad? Entonces, ¿cómo sería ahí?
Was, creo que está hablando de él.
Yes. But let me see. What nationality was your first English teacher? It's okay, right?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. Sí, porque está hablando de una tercera persona. Le está preguntando a usted de qué nacionalidad fue su primer maestro de inglés. Está hablando de él, entonces sería was. Now, what about number four?
Where you born in this city?
Were you born in this city? Is okay or no?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Were you born in this city? Now,
When was your
where,
mother born? No.
when, ¿qué sería ahí?
Was.
Was.
When was, porque está hablando de una tercera persona también, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Ok. When was your mother born? Ok, now. Ok, como ya las completamos, complete these questions with was or were, ahora las vamos a responder. Ok, what about the first one? Where were your parents born? Tell me your correct information, your own information, su propia información. The question is for Lillian. Where
Okay.
were your parents born? ¿Dónde nacieron sus padres?
My parents born in, oh, he was born
O puede ser they were born
were born in Ahuachapán.
in Ahuachapán.
Yes,
Es
my mother was born in Ataco. And my father was born in Jutla.
Was born in Ataco. And my father was born
En Jutla.
Acajutla.
No, Jutla.
Jujutla.
Sí. Yes.
Ah, okay. And then They were born in Aguachapán. My mother was born. Entonces lo pongámosle. My mother was born. My mother was born in Ataco and my father was born in Jujutla. Now, questions number two is for forever. Were you and your family in this city last year? Were you and your family in this city last year? ¿Estuvo usted y su familia en esta ciudad el año pasado? Bien, deme una respuesta corta.
We were
¿Cómo sería una respuesta corta?
yes,
Aquí sería, la respuesta corta sería así, mire, yes. Yes, we were. Como la pregunta inicia con were, entonces la respuesta va a ser we were, la respuesta corta. Mire, yes, we were. Sí, dice, estuvimos. Esto quería que vieran también. Miren qué importante esto. Yes, we were. Sí, nosotros estuvimos. ¿Y cómo sería la respuesta larga? Podría ser así, mire, Ever. We were in, en la colonia Escalón, digamos. In Escalón Residential. En Residencial Escalón. Were you and your family in this city last year? Yes, we were. Sí, estuvimos. We were in Escalón Residential. Nosotros estuvimos en la Residencial Escalón. Is okay? Or do you have any question? Hello?
It's
Okay,
okay.
it's okay. Now,
It's okay.
question number three is for Anita. What nationality was your first English teacher?
My teacher,
Invent. You can invent.
my teacher, his nationality
Digamos que
was
es
Mexico.
americana, mexicana, ¿ok? Entonces podemos ponerle her
Her
nationality
nationality.
o he, si fue hombre o mujer. Bueno, si fue mujer. Her nationality, su nacionalidad,
Is
is Mexican.
Mexico.
Mexican,
Mexican.
mexicana.
Okay.
¿Ya? Su nacionalidad es mexicana. Acá le estoy preguntando, ¿de qué nacionalidad fue su primer maestro de inglés? ¿Ya? Aunque podría ponerle, su nacionalidad fue tal lugar, tal cosa.
Or
Entonces, ¿cómo
she
sería la
were born
respuesta?
in Mexico.
También was Mexican.
She
O
were
también
born in
puede ser
Mexico.
she was
She
born
was born in Mexico.
in México. También, mire, she was born
Okay.
in México. Now, next question is for Nazario. Were you born in this city? Tell me a short answer. Una yes no question. Were you born
Yes,
in this city?
yes, yes.
Yes, what? Yes,
I
I
were born.
was. Yes, I
I was
was.
born.
Solamente sería
Yes, I
yes, I
was.
was. La respuesta corta, yes, I was. Porque como iniciamos preguntándole con was, significa que iniciamos preguntándole por were, ¿verdad? Pero como es para usted y para mí, voy a utilizar was. Le voy a poner yes, I was. Were you
It's a
born
short
in
answer.
this city? Yeah, is the short answer. Now,
I was born
I was born
in Santana City.
In Santa Ana City. Excellent. Now, when was your mother born? Ya está ahí Luis Chávez. Luis Chávez.
Teacher.
Hi.
He was born San Salvador.
Sería, when was your mother born? ¿Dónde nació su mamá? ¿Cómo sería entonces la respuesta? She was born. Ay, que tiene interferencia, ¿verdad, Luisito?
No, yo perfecto.
Ah, ok. And then the answer is, she was born in San Salvador, right?
She's okay.
Okay, thanks a lot. Now, Juan, are you there? No, Juan todavía no está. And then, Lilian again. Ah, here, ¿cómo sería aquí? Was or where? When? When were you born, Lilian? When were you born?
I was born in 1994.
I was born 1994.
Four, yes.
Okay, excellent. Now, do you have any questions for this exercise? Acá lo importante es, solo recuerden esto, miren. Háganse, eso se llama mapa mental, mind map. Usted puede analizar y solo decir was, ah, was va con I y con las terceras personas, que es con he, she, it. Y lo demás todo va a ser where. Where, que va para you, we, and they. ¿Se aprende uno en memoria o se aprende los dos o solo where? Y ahí vas a ver que el was lo va a utilizar solo para ellos, para I, he, she, it, terceras personas y I. ¿Ya? Así les va a costar menos. Si aprenden esto, cómo va el uso y lo pueden ir haciendo, right? Si gustan, si tienen tiempecito, y para práctica, pueden hacer preguntas y respuestas, unas 5 preguntas y respuestas en su notebook, como tarea. Eso puede ser una tarea, pero si tienen tiempo y desean practicar, intenten hacer unas 5 oraciones con preguntas y respuestas. ¿Cuál va a usar primero? Va a usar el was y where. El was y where. También va a ser otras 5 podrían ser usando así, miren. O puede ser una, 2 y 2. 2 de estas utilizando primero, poniendo como pregunta el was y where, así como esto. Y otras 2 poniendo esto. Primero las W question al inicio. 2 con esta, 2 con esta y 5 en general. Usando ambas, así como esto. Serían 9 por todas. Si quiere hacer más, pues está bien. Haga más para practicar. Con esta, miren con las preguntas. Primero de esta puede hacer 2 con preguntas y respuestas, así como está aquí. Con la short answer. Y si quiere, también le puede poner una respuesta larga. Para practicar. Igual con este. Pregunta y respuesta. Ya, es como práctica. Ok. And then, this is the end of our class. Vaya, por favor, los ejercicios de la plataforma, no se les olvide que tienen que enviarlos, los ya de la unidad que acabamos de finalizar el día de ayer. Eso tienen que mandarlo ya o mañana, más tardar, ¿verdad? Y solamente nos quedan 2 clases, el lunes y martes. Por favor, no se pierdan la clase y hay que conectarse temprano porque vamos a tratar de avanzar lo más que podamos el lunes para el martes hacer una unos ejercicios involucrando todo, el did, el was, el were, para que les sea más fácil. ¿Ya? And then, have a nice weekend. And thanks for coming. And see you on Monday.
Okay, teacher. Bye. See you Monday. Okay.
See you Monday. And have a nice weekend. Night. Thanks, you. Good night.
Good night.
See you.